In addition to the five voices that you will hear up at this microphone today, there are other voices far more important that will be heard in the future. The 870,000 people who, as of this morning, have signed the petition at impeachdonaldtrumpnow.org live in every community of the United States. That number continues to grow. We know that in a matter of days it will cross the 1 million threshold and keep going. Those names are much more than letters on a printed page or pixels on a screen. They're people who care deeply about the Constitution, who understand that it's a fundamental precept of democracy that no one is above the law, that the most powerful position of the U.S. government must not be occupied by someone who has shown willingness, even eagerness, to violate fundamental precepts of the Constitution. And what we're going to be seeing that may not yet be apparent from Capitol Hill is that around the United States, not only the signers of this petition so far, but many, many millions of other people believe deeply that when the people lead, the leaders will follow. And this petition campaign is based on that concept. So the petition is only one part of what is going to begin to unfold in the next several weeks. And that is that in every congressional district in this country, people have already begun and will continue in greater numbers to contact their representative in the House and to say in no uncertain terms that no one is above the law and that in this situation, whatever the partisan affiliation of the member of the House, it's imperative to launch a formal impeachment investigation. Now, we sometimes hear the skepticism, maybe even cynicism, that nothing's going to happen in the House on impeachment because most of the members are Republicans. And I think we need to remind ourselves that history tells us something very different. When in 1974 the House Judiciary Committee voted on impeachment, on three articles of impeachment of the Republican President Richard Nixon, out of the 38 members of that committee, seven Republicans voted for impeachment. And there are many strong reasons, not only in history, but in our current political situation, to believe that large numbers of members of the House, whatever their party, are going to be feeling the heat. And that heat has begun. And next week, the temperature will rise as members go back to their districts, some of them holding town hall meetings, some of them being visited by their constituents to press this point. And so in closing, I want to emphasize that the ImpeachDonaldTrumpNow.org campaign is not by any means only about a petition drive. This is about an awakening democratic fervor at the grassroots that will bring about the impeachment of this president.